In cell C26, we're going to put in an if function. The if function requires three arguments. Now, the purpose of the if function in this particular exercise is to check cell E3 to determine if it has a value of 1. If cell E3 does have a value of 1, the second argument is the value that will show up in cell C26. So in this case, if cell E3 has a 1, we're going to use the value that is in cell K8. If the value in E3 is not a 1, we're going to use the third argument, the value which is the third argument. In this case, K16, the value of K16. So by using this if function, this spreadsheet, cell C26, can check cell E3. If it's a 1, then it's going to use K8. If it's a 2, it's going to use cell K16. So K16 is using this value. The 1 would use this value. Once you've got the if function completed for cell C26, use the autofill to copy the formula to the remaining cells within that row, cells D26 through N26. Now the autofill, you have to make sure that your mouse pointer points at the lower right corner of the cell, so you get the solid plus sign, and then we drag over to N26 and let go, and it copies the full value. Now, of course, the value is going to be the same because we used absolute cell references, not relative. That was the dollar signs. Say, absolutely use cell E3, absolutely use K8. Because it doesn't matter which cell we are in row 26, we're going to be testing on cells E3, and depending on the value of E3, we're going to use either K8 or K16. If we were to change the value in cell E3 to a 1, then the values in cells C26 through N26 should reflect 2549. Let's change E3 to a 1 and scroll down and notice the values of cells C26 through N26 have changed.